Now students, we learn more about triangles. What is in the interior of the triangle and what is exterior of the triangle. So we have taken a plane. The area which is covered is the plane, and in this plane a triangle is there. We take a triangle. Suppose A, B, C. Vertices are A, B, C. Point A, point B, point C are the vertices. AB, BC, AC. These three sides and angle A, angle B, angle C are the angles. Now I take points P, Q, R, S. These points are in the interior of this triangle. If I take here a point M, N, O, if I take the point on the triangle, then they are in the triangular region. Interior points plus my points on the triangle are in triangular region. And if I take some point here that is not on the triangle or inside the triangle, they are outside the triangle. So these points are exterior of the triangle. So what is the interior points? P, Q, R and S. Triangular region points A, M, B, N, C, O, P, Q, R and S. These are triangular region points. And exterior of the triangle are X, Y, Z. These are exterior points. So now if you see in your book, look at the triangle. Triangle ABC is there. Part of the plane which consists of point like PQR. Here PQR are given. These are the interior of the triangle. Interior of the triangle along with or together with the points on the triangle A, M, B, T, C, and these are triangular region, and the points outside the triangle X, Y, Z, these are exterior of the triangle. So now next we have to find the side opposite to a vertex and vertex opposite to a side. So for this we take one triangle, suppose A, B and C. We take one side BC. What is the opposite vertex of this side BC? If the opposite vertex will be this point A, vertex A. So opposite vertex of the side BC is vertex A. If we talk about the side AB, then what will be the opposite vertex? Opposite vertex is C, which is not on the side. That is the opposite vertex of that side. If we talk about AC, side AC, then opposite vertex will be, B is not here, so that will be vertex B. Similarly, if I take first vertex A, then what will be the opposite side to vertex A? Opposite side to vertex A is BC. opposite side to vertex B is, opposite side will be AC, and opposite side to vertex C will be AB. So in your book here XYZ triangle is given. If I take Y as vertex, opposite side will be XZ. If I take Z as vertex, opposite side will be XY. If I take X as vertex, opposite side will be YZ or ZY. Similarly here, opposite side will be XY to vertex Z. To vertex X, it is YZ or ZY. So we move to worksheet 2 now. In the given triangle, name the vertex opposite to QR. This triangle PQR is given to you, and you have to tell the vertex opposite to QR. This is QR side, and vertex opposite to this is vertex P. So you will write vertex P. Side opposite to vertex Q. Here is vertex Q, and side opposite will be PR. So here we can write side PR. Side opposite to vertex R. Here is the vertex R, and side opposite will be PQ. Side PQ. Vertex opposite to side PQ. Here we have PQ, and vertex opposite to side is R. So we have vertex R. In question number 2, draw any triangle ABC and mark the points XY in the interior of the triangle ABC, RS in the exterior of the triangle ABC. So for this we will take our registers. So first of all we will write question number 2, and in A part, first of all we have to draw triangle with the use of a pencil. Triangle name is ABC. This is A part. We have to find XY in the interior. So write down XY in the interior of triangle ABC. So where we will put in the interior, anywhere you can put X and Y, but in the interior of this triangle. Then in B part, you have to write RS in the exterior of the triangle ABC. RS in the exterior of the triangle. So again we draw the triangle ABC. And we have to take RS in the exterior of this triangle. So we take these points. Now in question number 3, what do you mean by a triangular region? So here it is written, the interior of the triangle together with the triangle is called the triangular region. So the interior of the triangle together with the triangle is called triangular region. Now look at question number 4. Look carefully at the following figure and name all the triangles formed. The triangles which have the point P in its exterior, the triangles which have the point P in its interior. So first of all we will write the triangles formed in our registers. First of all, make this figure in your registers. Write question number A, all the triangles formed and its answer. How many triangles are formed in it? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 triangles. Then here it will 5, 6, 7 and 8. So here 8 triangles are formed. So first of all, write the names of the triangles. First we'll take this triangle AOD. So first this is the sign of triangle AOD. Then this triangle AOB. Triangle AOB. Then the next triangle BOC. Triangle BOC. Then the next triangle COD. Triangle COD. Then our next triangle with one ABC. This is also one triangle ABC. If we will take this BCD. Triangle BCD. ACD or ADC. You can take any one. ACD. Triangle ACD. Now, triangle ABD. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 triangles are done. So here 8 triangles are formed. And next you have to find the triangles which have the point P is in the exterior. So P is in the exterior of these 3 triangles and plus this and this triangle. So write down all the names. So first of all, write down triangle in its answer. Triangle AOD, COD, triangle COD, triangle BOC. In AOB, P is in the interior, so we will not write. Then here ACD and BCD. In these triangles, P is in the exterior. Now, next is the triangles which have the points P in its interior. In the interior, we have AOB. Then ABC. Then ABD. So in these triangles, P is in the interior. Here P is in the exterior. Here are the triangles formed in this figure. In question number 5, in the given figure, name the triangles which have A as an vertex. Any two triangles you have to name where A is the vertex. So here is a figure. You can write ABC, you can write ADE, you can write ADF, you can write ABF, ACF, ACE. So here is A can be the vertex, but you have to write any two. So in your notebooks, draw this figure. And write the question and the answer. So you can write any two triangles with vertex A. So I'm writing ABC, ABF or ADC. You can write any one. Now in B, B as one vertex. Now you have to take B as one vertex and any two. So in B you can take B, C, D. You can take A, B, F. Here B is also one of the vertex. A, B, C. Here also B is one of the vertex. You can write in C E as one vertex. Any two. Now E as one vertex. So we will write A, D, E is one of the vertex. So we will write triangle A, D, E. One more, A, E, C, D, E, F also. This is one of the triangles, so we can write D, E, F. You have to write only two, so write only two. Next, D, F as one side, any two. Here you have to take D, F as one side. So D, E, F, in this D, F is one of the side, so we can write triangle D, E, F. One more, D, F, C, this is also one triangle, so D, F, C you can take. Now in next part, B, C as one side. Here BC has one side and you have to write the triangle. So you can write ABC, DBC, triangle ABC, triangle DBC. These are two triangles where BC is one of the side. Now in F, AE as one side. Here AE, then AED, this is one of the triangle. AEC, this is one of the triangle. Now the triangle is there with AE as side, so we will write triangle AED, triangle AEC. So this completes your worksheet 2 of chapter 12.